It's me, Kennedy. So the one thing that I really wanted to talk about in this video was actually the Trinity and just learning, getting the opportunity to sit and study that and be taught that and get to read a book written by theologists on that was really a cool opportunity because I've grown up knowing obviously about the Trinity and Father, Son, Holy Spirit, and how they are one and they are each other, but I've never really understood that or taken the time to sit down and study that. So there are a couple things that just like really stuck out to me that I got to read in the book and also that Shane got to teach us. So yeah, like I kind of touched on before this, it wasn't like a huge part in my faith because I just didn't really like understand it. I just knew it was a thing. And so specifically one example of that, which is really cool for me, was in the book, there's like a small paragraph that I definitely had to read like multiple times to understand it and to just kind of understand what it was saying. But after I read it a couple times, it was like this revelation of like, okay, that actually for the first time, like I understand the Trinity. And I mean, more than I ever have before, at least, because I don't think anyone can fully comprehend it. But so the paragraph, bear with me. It says, "We believe that Jesus Christ is Lord, that he is God, and that we ought to worship him as such. We know that the Holy Spirit is God, and we worship the Spirit also as God. At the same time, in the Gospels, Jesus speaks of God as being both one with him and the other than him. Jesus Christ, while being God, is the only way that leads to God, and we know that the Holy Spirit leads to Jesus." So, once again, like I said, kind of confusing, but it all just kind of makes sense, and it all just kind of proves that, like, each leads to each other, and they're distinct. We learned in class that each of them are distinct, but they all, like, lead to each other in some way. So, they're distinct, but they're one. And see, now that I'm like on the other end of it, it's really hard to teach. But one thing that I also found really cool that we got the opportunity to sit in class and learn was Shane gave us scriptural evidence that the Father is God, the Son is God, and the Spirit is God. And some of those just being like Genesis 1:1, that the Father is God. And that one's just kind of obvious. And then Matthew 9:2 says that, like, the Son forgives sins and only God can forgive sins. So just the correlation between the Son forgiving sins when we know that only our God can do that. And then also Jesus in Matthew commands the angels, and that's just a sign because only God can command his angels. And so we also got examples of the Spirit being God. And in Acts, actually, not in Acts, in John, the Spirit performs works of God. And so that just kind of leads us to, obviously, like, he has to have God in him or, like, be God because he's performing acts that only our God can perform. And he has equality with God. So there's just many different things and different proofs that I was able to hear and read up on and even read further in those verses in the Bible just to get more of like the contrast and, I mean, context and just understand it a little bit more. And then also it was kind of interesting learning about the Trinitarian heresies, even though they were definitely confusing. And in class we watched a video on, I forget what saint it was, but he was trying to explain the Trinity to these little like elf guys or something, and every time you tried to explain it, they would label it with a Trinitarian heresy, and that just blew me away, because every time then I would go home and, like, try to explain it to myself, I would find myself, like, hitting a heresy, and that's just crazy to me, and that just fully shows that we will never be able to comprehend it, but yeah, so now I just feel like I know a lot more of the Trinity, and I'm just, like, a lot more confident in it, and it's added to my relationship, because not only has it just brought new knowledge to my relationship between me and God and Jesus and the Holy Spirit, but it just gives me more to study and more alone time, and it's helping me to learn new things about me and my relationship with Him. Every time I sit down and just like look at it more, and I'm able to share this information now that I have with people who might have questions about it. And I think it's really powerful to point back to verses, because like that's the plain truth, the hardcore truth, is the Bible. So I just thought it was really cool. It was one of the things that I probably enjoyed learning the most. So yeah, thank you, Shane, for this class, and I'm excited to use all of the information that I've learned, not just on the Trinity, and portray that and help other people just kind of be in kind of the same spot I'm at and being more confident in my relationship with God. So yeah, thanks.